Hello everyone, my squad. My name is Ian and I am back for more Union Cross. Yes, we got Union Cross, finally. I've been waiting for it since it came out on the 23rd, so it went- Oh, Heartless! Oh, Captain.
Ah, I'm killing all the Heartless.
Well, this is interesting.
We're all dead.
And I don't know why this is so fun. Tap, 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 tap. Tap, tap. Yay. Okay, let's hope this downloads quickly. Oh. Well, kinda. Considering I'm in my bedroom, in which there's... the internet connection is not that quick, so... But I hope it downloads quickly because I only have around 17 minutes to record. So I need to be quick because there are 12 notices. And I plan to do a lot, so- Oh! It's going faster, good, 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 good! The faster it goes, the better we go. What? Why is this minigame so fun? It's just tapping shadows. Tap, tap, tap- Oh no, you missed my fury. Hey Arthur! Oh. I think I defeated them all- Oh! No, 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 no! Ha! I did it. I'm the best murderer. Sorry. But yeah, guys. I'm really happy Union Cross has finally released for the American version. And I'm just excited for so many reasons. Like, we have the trait system. I can pull for Tyree. I can do a guaranteed pull for her. There are the new avatar boards, in which I'm curious as to what they have. I'm wondering if they have Mickey Brooms. There's just so much to do! And I'm really excited, and I hope I get Gear 5 because I he didn't escape. Huh. I hope the new boards have the making rooms because then I can kill Tyree and get Gear 5. But let's see. And seems as if all the after boards are back also, so premium after boards. Okay, we just finished for this to load, download, and then we start this. I'm probably going to cut out most of the downloading parts. Oh, Heartless, 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 Heartless. They're all dead. Yep. How dare you? How dare you keep on being alive? Actually, they're technically already dead, right? I mean, they are the things that try to steal people's hearts, so they're not really alive, right? Also, I just thought up of something. Will there be nobodies in Union Cross? Like, obviously we have the Heartless, many Heartless, but what about nobodies? Will they make an appearance? Because from what I know, the first time they appeared on was in Kingdom Hearts 2. However, there were nobodies before Kingdom Hearts 2, right? So maybe we'll see Heartless in Union Cross? Not so sure. But it would be nice to see... It would be cool to see a nobody like a Dusk in Union Key 4. Imagine that. It would be really cool. And here is the wave part. Do I get something for doing this, or is it just to keep me entertained while this downloads? Okay, it's finished downloading. Touch, touch, touch. No, come on, no shadow shall live. Okay. 4 minutes to download, 5. Well, considering it's such a huge update, that's not that much time. But... Okay. Yes! It's complete! Okay, 12 notices, let's go, let's go. I'm excited. I would really like to live stream this, but I still don't have the proper equipment to stream the amazing update that is 2.0. Okay, just let the game load and we'll see what we have. So 12 notices, I'm ready for them. My body's ready, let's go. Oh, there's already an error. Okay, so here. Past avatar boards return. Celebrate our first year with an encore of past avatar boards. So there will only be 1,500 jewels apiece. Okay then, like,
Oh, and per week there's some... Okay, that's nice to know. So you can choose what skills slash boards you want. Oh, this is nice to know. Attack boost all too. I surely want attack boost all too. Attack boost 1. Holy crap, attack boost 1. Really? Lux plus, like just Lux plus. Wow. Attack press plus and attack boost 2. No cost and attack boost 2. Poison all the pluses and attack boost 2. And yeah, that's it. Okay. Interesting. Oh, I already clicked on this. Extra purchase jewels, yeah, bonus jewels and skip tickets. Awaken your metal traits. We explain the traits mechanic. When you fuse a metal to another metal with the same name and rarity, in other words, a metal with the same album number, you will unlock the metal's trait. And like skills, a metal's trait is always active. Addition to be metal will not unlock traits on a metal. And traits, there are many different traits to unlock, and the trait that you get will be randomly decided each time you perform the metal fusion. The number of traits you can have on a metal called slots differ from metal to metal. But here's the deal, all metals that are tier 2, no, up until tier 3 can only have one trait. Traits that are tier 4s and above have two traits. So you have the option of overriding one of the metals. So let's say if you want plus 1000 strength instead of ground enemy defense, you can override it. Now we have max gauges plus 2, which gives you 2 gauges, max HP plus 800, which is really good. Poison resistance 3 plus 3, and yeah. So this affects everything on your keyblade. Now, here are the metal, the effects that traits only affect your metal. Ground enemy defense by minus 20, it decreases the defense of ground enemies by 20%, same thing on the aerial. Damaging rate plus 40%, extra attack 40% power, allows you to use a second metal as the metal a second time, but it only has 40% of the original power. And this is the one I went for my Magnus and B. Introducing Theater mode. So now we can watch all the story cutscenes in Theater right here. As long as you have unlocked that quest, you can revisit it at any time. Update notes. Ooh. Okay, let's see. Okay, design, opening cutscene, title screen, BGM, multiplayer mode, theater mode, metal traits, strength buffs are now up to 7, and debuffs also. You'll be able to reduce the cost of up to 20 using 6 star seed medals. You'll be able to recruit players that belong to a party. Ooh. Game data will now be downloaded after a player completes the tutorial. Oh, okay. The ability to unlock special attack bonus on a metal will now be achieved up on quest 34. So now you can unlock guilt at quest 34 instead of 200, which is a giant boost in gaming. Like, holy crap. Union Cross, added to the quest page, special attack bonus tier. So most of these you will notice, like, oh, this is good to know. Okay, this is really good to know. Okay, next up, story quest update. We have added 30 new story quests. So, first 15 are about Aladdin, and the other ones are for adding the new world. And we get the Stroke of Midnight. Yes, this keyboard is really good. And every Wednesday we get the Adamantite Ore Challenge and materials for the Stroke of Midnight, so be sure to hang on to these. Union Cross Launch Campaigns. So... Daily Seed Quest! Daily Seed Quest for everyone! Oh, I gotta do this! Oh, yes! Yes! Okay. So during... Now up until April 25th, we get 3 seeds every day! Yes! Yes! 66 medals, holy crap, I need those. All quests and raids are 0 AP. All quest, story quests gave the triple lux. no guilt in campaign, it seems, but however, I don't care. Beginner's deals return permanently. Ooh! Wait, what? Oh, single targets, all targets, and utility deals, which are buffered. This is nice to know, like, for beginners, this is really great. Especially considering you get SIDs from these. Okay, let's go back. Flashy party avatars. Now we have two dancers. We have the juggler and dancer. And... oh! Attack boost 3 and attack price plus and lux plus! So we can get a speed gem from each board, a SID 10. It doesn't seem like there are any Mickey and Brooms. Holy crap! An SP attack each, 1 attack boost 3 max? 3 skills! Okay, this is really good. Okay, let's just... I'm going to jump this one right now. Just for now. First anniversary quest, so... we can earn up to 2,000 jewels. Get out. 1 through 15 are available right now, and start from April 20th, we'll get 16 through 30. So, it's just some story access things. Post update, we have confirmed an issue causing the app to crash. Okay, now this is the one I'm the most excited for. Anniversary! The time for the breathtaking Illustrated Kingdom Hearts 2 medal. And to commemorate our 1 year anniversary and the release of Kingdom Hearts Union Cross, you will get her within 5 draws from this anniversary medal, Carnival, and pre-strengthened to 3 attack dots. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to get this amazing medal with such a merciful number of pulls. It's also the perfect chance to get additional Illustrated Kingdom Hearts 2 Kyrie medals in order to attempt to unlock the extra attack trait, which will allow you to use her special attack. Now, this incredibly useful tier 5 medal has it all. She can restore HP and 10 special attack gains, raise her power, speed, and magic strength, lower enemies' power, speed, and magic defense, and deal fixed damage. This deal also introduced the tier 5 Illustrated Kingdom Hearts 2 Sora medal, as long as the tier 3 Yago and Monstro medals. These are the ones, and she costs 5, she's a tier 5. Ah, she's just so good! Sora is also really good. He deals 6 hits and lowers defense of all targets by 1 tier for 2 turns. He inflicts more damage to lower the slot number, so in slot number 1 he would be stronger. However, he's best used in slot number 2. And you are guaranteed to receive her within 5 pulls, and you get these 2. And if you get them boosted, they have plus 1000 more base strength and defense. So this really... get 5, huh? If you manage to unlock the special attack bonus for either Illustrated Kingdom Hearts 2 Kyrie or Illustrated Kingdom Hearts 2 Sora before April 25th, you will receive the incredibly powerful tier 5. Oh, for either! I can just kill her if I am lucky enough and get this! Ah, it's tier 5, it's here! It's here! It's just here! Okay. I don't think I have enough time to pull for her right now, but hold that. 5,000 free jewels, okay. They said they were going to give the extra 1,000 later. Free Sora and Roxas's. Guys, I think I'm going to try to guild her. I don't care if it's so many jewels. I think I'm going to try to guild her before April 25th. Oh. Okay, so we got Gooby and Donald. Juggler, Dancer, Mirror Set. Wait, what? Okay, let me grab everything. So 50 jewels right here. The 300 jewels for the maintenance. The 5,000 jewels, which will get 1,000 more, and 7 Sora and Roxas's. Holy crap, I have 21,000, 9,000 more. I have... April 6th. I have 19 days. Is that enough to get? 9,000 jewels. I think it is. And the music changed here as well. Now guys, I am going to do something quite crazy. I am going to guild these, but I'm going to guild them in the next bar. And on the next bar, I'll also do the poll for Tyree. I'm just so excited! Ah! But anyways guys, that is all. Actually no, I'm going to make this one whole video. I don't care if it's going to have like 15 minutes. Let's go. I'll be right back. Okay, back to part 2. Now, first of all, we have Sora and Roxas to guild. They are the dual mastery. They deal 13 moderately powerful hits and slightly recover HP. Now, here's something really good about them. They already come with 36 cost. Now, you can put the cost down by 20 now, which means that they can get to 16 cost, which is exactly the same as a, well, not exactly the same, but practically a 5-star medal, which is really, really nice. Now, I'm going to show you how the same traits, how this works, the trait system. So, bring one here, and it explains to you how the trait works. Now, only put one, make sure to only put one. And, let's see what I get. Sora and Roxas, man. I thought they were going to be better, but I'm not complaining. They're quite good. Okay, let's see. And plus 800 HP. Not bad. But I'm thinking of putting triple threat on them. Okay, I'm going to jump the animation just for this to be quicker. Let's see. And I got the same thing. Okay, I'm gonna override it. And we get every enemy defense by minus 20. Eh, not really interesting. Oh yeah, I forgot to jump the animation, okay. And 1,000 strength. Okay, for now I'm going to put this in. Not bad, not bad. Now it's the same as boosted metal. Boosted metals are always nice. And let's see what we get now. And we got ground enemy defense minus 20. Okay, don't care. Last one. Now we boost, no, it's not boost, sorry, it's EXP. And also guys, something really cool. Take a look at this. We have extra things, so now we have even more options on what we want to be. Like, we can be more specific on skills, on gauges, on hits, like, holy crap, this is just too good. Okay, but now let's guild them. And let's see how high of a roll we get. I know we're not in Guilty Campaign, but however, I still want to try it. Let's see. And we get 72! Not bad! And they are boosted. Oh! Oh yeah, I forgot to trade. Let's see. Plus 2,000 defense. Okay, plus 1,000 attack is better. So maybe I'll use them in the future, since I have a boosted copy of Sora and Roxas. And I think I'm putting triple threat on them, but I'm not completely sure. Now, let's go for my lesson B, everyone! Let's give her traits also. And I hope I get the plus 1000 strength trait. I got it on Sora and Roxas, so please game, please give it to her also. Please. Let's see. And we get poison resist. And we get, okay, let's see. Plus 2000 defense. And for now I'm going to put it there, but I want plus 1,000 attack. Let's see. Please, game, please. And we get sweep resist. Don't care. Please, game, please. Give me 1,000 strength. Again? I don't need plus 2,000 defense, please. Please. No, I don't need poison resist. Okay. No, I don't need poison resist. Let's see. And we're guilting her, so this animation I'm not gonna jump. Okay, please be a good run, please give me plus 1000 strength. Please? 65, not bad. Okay, let's see what skill I get. Please, 1000 strength. Max gauge is plus 2, okay. This is good, so, but I don't wanna keep it, I want plus 1000 strength, please. Please. Game, please.
No, I don't need defense.
Let's go. I got plus 1,000 strength already. Please give it to me again. Let's go. And we get... I maxed out her guilt. Okay. Let's go, please. Please, let's go. I got an extra attack. I got an extra attack on her. Ooh. So 100% guilt and an extra attack. Huh. This is good, but I didn't get the plus 1000 strength, but this is good. Okay. And now I don't need to spend mirrors on her. Now, do I have anything else to give traits to? I have these ones, which I can do it later. But I have Lilac equipped, right? I do. It's time, guys. It's time to pull. Illustrating her suit, Kyrie guaranteed within 5 turns. Well, we have also these deals, but yeah, they're not... I don't like them really. Okay, 18 days. Let's go. Let's see what we get, guys. Ah, it's been so long since I pulled. And we get... Come on. Obviously, we're going to get a 6 star. A tier 4 or above. T. Okay. Ooh! Ventus! Okay. Kingdom Hearts 2 Black Old Riku B is also really good. This bitch is kind of... But Ventus! He might be quite useful in the future. Okay. Second pull for Tyree. Imagine if I get her right now, then I can do 5 more pulls so I can guilt her. Like, I hope this happens, but oh, it's a reversed. Okay then, let's see what we get. And we get... Illustrated Chion! Woo! Illustrated Chion! I got her! Not a Rock Titan, a Lee... Chion! She's here! Okay, this just helped out my... What's it called? My 3 wishes by a whole lot. But let's keep pulling, guys, I mean... This is going well! Let's see what we get now. Ooh! Another reversed! Oh, 2 reversed! Wait, what? Oh! SP Shion and HD Axel! Dude, it's HD Axel. SP Shion is not as good, but I got HD Axel. HD Shion and HD Axel, one pull away from the other. Okay, Kyrie's guaranteed within 2 pulls, 2 turns. Okay. Let's see. Oh, this is exciting, guys. Okay. Another upright. Let's see what this is. Wait. QR2. Oh. It's QR2. Okay. It's my first year 5. Like, that isn't a high score challenge. And Tyree is going to be on this poll. Oh, let's see. These have been some really good pulls. Holy crap. Okay. 2. Ooh, Illustrious Sora B. And Tyree. Radiance. Ah, we got her, guys. Another Piglet. Okay. I don't even care about Piglet. Wait. I'm going to wait a little bit to see how many jewels I think I can get. Oh, guys. We got some good medals. HD Axel. He's going to help out quite a lot in practically all my setups. And where is she? Where's my Tyree? Here she is. Here she is, guys. I got her. I'm sharing her. I don't care. Okay, I got her. The last part cut, as you may have noticed. But I did already prepare my Tyree. She already has minus 8 because I did give her the seeds from the daily seed quest. And I also prepared every single other tier 4 and 5 mail I got. So, I have some last things to do before I actually do the events. And multiplayer, because this is the main thing. Let's give a trait to Hercules and Phil. Let's see what we get. And we get extra attack, 40% power. It's good, but I don't think it's worth it on a metal that costs 5. Let's see what else we get. And we get defense plus 2000. Okay, this is not better. We have one more trait roll. Let's see what we get. And we get damage and raise 40%. Okay, the extra attack is better. Even though it's 10 gauges. Well, let's see what else we have. My HDXO is already leveled up. I'm going to give him an attack boost and attack price plus, maybe. What other premiums did I get? Power XO was the only power one. Oh yeah, Chips and Dales. I need to give them traits. Let's see. So this is the best one I have. Let's see what we get for them. Okay. And we get every enemy defense minus 20%. Great skill. Okay. Next rate. And we get boom. Damage rate plus 40%. Eh, I think that's better. I'm not sure. And try this, and let's see what we get. Again, damaging raids. I don't think I'm going to be using this metal very much anymore. Well, but one thing I am definitely going to do is I am going to... Oh yeah, let me combine Zaldin B. I know it's not going to guilt him, but it's going to give him a trait, so let's see what we get. So, unlock. And let's see. Kind of sad that I wasn't able to guild him, but hey, it happens. Let's see. Paralysis resist. Okay, then Zaldin B has a worthless skill. I got this illustrator B is also going to be really nice on my sleeping lion. What else did we get? My illustrator Ventus, he's already fully leveled up. My SP Shion also is fully leveled up. And Tyree, she's already shared. I'm going to give her a second chance probably when I get it. I got KR2, which is really nice. I wasn't expecting that. And also Illustrated Shion. Wow, these are all medals that are going to help me so much. And that was it for... Yeah, that's right. All of my other medals I have already rolled traits on, and not that many good stuff, but hey. Also, since we have plus 6 tiers of strength right now, I have made a very good setup for Starlight that I want to... Divine Rose that I want to share with you guys. So let the game load. This is actually the spot in the house with the best Wi-Fi, but... For some reason, it still takes quite a long while to load. Okay, so let me show you guys this in Colosseum. So this is the round, right? This is the round. And this setup's just kind of testing around stuff, but this is the setup. It's Aaron Flounder, then Sebastian, then Tyree, then my Tama, and then my Marluxia B. Well, this is up until I get a plus 6 strength booster, but this could prove to do lots of damage, so let's see. Let's just use Ariel, Sebastian, and
the Tyree. And let's see how much damage Marley B does. Okay. 145,000. Yes, I think I'm going to advance quite a lot in this Colosseum. Let's see. But it's so useful having like 10 gauges back instantly. Like, I'm just so happy. Okay. Let's keep going. 150,000 again. Wow. It's like, how is this even possible? Well, Tyree's broken, guys. I just hope I'm able to guild her so I can get KR5. KR5 will help me a lot in Starlight mainly. But here we go again. This time let's use Thelma to see how much damage she does. Okay, let's see. 24,000, wow. 24,000. 193,000. How is this type of damage even possible? Well, we now have all of this power available, guys. Let's test out multiplayer. I wanna see how it goes. Interesting. I'm gonna wait a little bit to see if we do get a Mickey and Brooms avatar board, but, well, if we don't, I'm just going to try my luck to get another Tyree. And yes, when we do multiplayer missions, we get coins, which we can use to get rewards. So, oh, look at all these layers. Like, for example, if we go over here, we have a Magic Mirror set 1. And it also gives 10 jewels. So 80 jewels, it seems. Some EXP medals, a magic mirror. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I was right. 80 jewels. Some Huey and Louie's money medals and 2 magic mirrors. Not that bad, but huh. Let's see what they make the rewards on this. Now let's try this out. Okay then, so this is going to be the multiplayer part now. Just a quick little warning, I did record another multiplayer attempt, but in that one I wasn't able to do anything. So this time I'm actually going to do it with my party. So I always bring in this setup right now, because they are the AoE medal and Zigbar B is the main single hitter. So, according to King, we are going to start an update quest right now. I just hope it isn't the dark side one, because if it is, then I'm not gonna have enough time. But here it is, here's King. Let's see if any other party members join. If not, well, then we're gonna have to depend on random people that decide to enter this. So let's hope we get this right. So it seems as if we have to wait. Oh, Nanya is also here. Mog is here. Let's see if two more people enter. But multiplayer is really cool. You're gonna see it. It's quite awesome. But King just asked me to let you know that the amount of lag may be ridiculous, so let's see if the lag is real or not. Well, it seems as if we're going. Let's hope it doesn't lag too much. Yeah, it's lagging. Okay, so the target is to defeat all enemies. So let's say hi. Hi. Okay. Boom. And I got a chest. Okay, let's go. Oh, someone left the quest already. 4 players. Okay, defeat all enemies. Oh, wait. Oh, we have to rush. Wait, what? We were to do a target mission, but it seems as if we're already completed it. Oh. I don't know if you noticed, but it's quite hard to notice what's going on sometimes. Okay. Everybody seems to have a Gilded Bell and Beast, huh? Okay. And those little chests that we get, those chests give out union coins. These coins are the coins that you get completing the union key boards, which give you magic mirrors, jewels. Actually, not that many jewels, it's only 10 per quest. So 10 per... Let me lower the volume, please. Okay. Okay, objective, we have to rush 5 enemies. Okay, go, 3 enemies. Let's go over here. Invisible. Oh, I think I chose the wrong group of enemies. Unless we are somehow able to do this in time. Okay, second sally, please trigger. Yes, they triggered, okay. And we did it. Okay. We have 21 enemies left to complete this quest. Let's go over here. Well, it isn't that laggy. I thought it was going to be laggier, but it's not that bad. Okay, Sebastian, let's go. Boom. Okay. It's kind of hard to comment on multiplayer because you have to focus on everything at all. Oh, it's the shadow. Okay then. We had to focus on everything at all times, so 13 left. Why does it warn us that specifically 13 enemies left? Interesting. Okay. Yes, the lag is real. Let's keep going. Oh, Ringadings. And it's funny that I still haven't gotten to the Cinderella quest, so I have never seen them on my story quests. And I got another chest, good. Okay, let's go up here to defeat this high wizard. And yes, it's kind of chaotic as you can see. The multiplayer action. I don't know what's happening. Just step. Yay! We defeated. Okay, 5 enemies left. Oh, search goes. Okay then, keep going. The enemies aren't really that strong in this mission, but there is a really, really difficult... A really difficult target that you can reach. Which is the dark side, but he's like another level of difficult because he has like plus 50 bars and yeah, you don't want to mess with him. Oh, someone has a Meowgesy. Okay then. One enemy left. Let's go. Is it the target? Oh, possessors. Makes sense. Okay. At least they're level 150. They have a lot of HP bars, but they're not that strong. Is that everybody buff? Let's go! Now we use Jack and Sally. 4000 damage per hit. Now we use our Nova. Boom. Now Zig Barbie, go! Attack with the trigger, so it's dead. Yeah, 57,000 damage per hit. I think that was kind of... Oh, we did it! Yay! That was... Okay, we're like... Boom! They're dead. I don't think I have enough time, guys, to do a second part, a second multiplayer part. I only have 9 minutes to record right now. And multiplayer sessions are quite long, especially the dark side ones. The dark side ones can have up to 20 minutes. Like, oh, you can easily surpass 30 turns, even if all players are really, really strong. So. These were all people from my party, Mog, Kalo, and King. Now I want to show you really quickly the boards, the multiplayer, the cross boards. Because as you can see, we get cross coins. And depending on the quest, you may get more or less. I know that the dark side gives 195 if you defeat it. The behemoth gives 150, which isn't that much, sincerely, because... Oh, game, stop. Don't lag out on me. Okay. So I'm only on Magic Mirror set 1. And according to Axel, well, he got to the third one already. And I'm still on the first one. So
we got Huey, Dewey, Louis, Huey, Dewey, and Louis, and Moogles, and a Imagine Mirror at the end. And each and every single one of these gives 10 jewels. So 80 jewels if you complete each set, which is it's not that much. However, I think it's better than nothing.
So anyways, guys, I am going to end this part here. This has been the multiplayer segment, and I hope you enjoyed the next segment. Be right back. The recording just keeps cutting, and I was fighting a level 150 Darkseid. Holy crap, he had 2 million HP. And I was like, I passed 26 turns. And then the phone was like, oh, you gotta charge. And I was like, okay. I plugged it into charge, and it turned off in my face. The moment I connected the charger, and I was like, you! I didn't even have any words, because I was there more than 20 minutes fighting that dark side. It's like 4 people left and 4 other people came in to help. And I still wasn't able to defeat. We were really close. I was only like 500,000 away. And yet, it wasn't enough. However, what is enough and I can do right now are the Proud Plus quests. Now, sincerely, with the plus 7 buffs, these have become quite literally a joke. So the Proud Quest power, I am bringing in Moogle Gore with this setup. We have first of all Sebastian, then we have Arian Flounder, then we have Tyree, her beautiful, beautiful Tyree. Then we have my Molesson Bee with 100% and the extra attack 40% power, and we have our World of Final Fantasy Qual. And for our friend Metal, we're bringing in Anya's 150% Gilted HD Ursula. And like, it looks so much better now, everything looks so much neater, and I just love this update, holy crap. Let's see, I believe that is all. And yeah, this person guy, Dark Riku. No, I don't want the Dark Riku, he's awesome, but nah. Let's go with Anya. And you'll see how easy this will become. And let's go. And bam. Now, we first of all use both the buffers right here. Then we use Tyree. And now take a look at how much damage Molesson B does. Yep. 44,000 damage per hit. 44,000. That's so much damage. Imagine with an attack boost 3 max. She's just going to wreck everyone. And Tyree helps out so much. I love that I got her. Let's see. Please? Okay, she didn't trigger. But still 30,000 damage per hit. I knew this meta was worth it. Now, even though the second ability is really nice, I don't know if that is the best ability to give her. I might have to compare damage. But still, let's go. And she triggered again, 40,000 per hit. 2 whole bars per hit. This meta is amazing. And I'm just going through 3 minutes of video and I'm already at the second to last enemy. This is the power of Molesson B, guys. And let's go. Boom. 43,000 damage per hit. Guys, I'm just so happy with this update in general. This, as you may have noticed, is a setup that mostly focuses on her. If we do get to a point where I can get 0.2 carry, which I believe I'm going to save up for her next, I don't need both Sebastian and Arian Flounder. I just need Kingdom Hearts 2 carry. Sorry. 0.2 carry here, Tyree here, then a reverse power metal here, and then Molesson B. But holy crap. Maybe 7SB, maybe HDX, so I got one. I got an HDX, so maybe he's better, but I'm not sure. Let's see. Now we use Tyree. And let's hold Molesson B procs. Let's see. And she does 40,000 damage per hit. Now, I know this is wasting gauges, however I want to see how much damage she does in the second turn. Okay, 16,000 is still quite a lot. Now, let's see. Nova doing 50,000 damage per hit. Wow. And now we use Aenia's HD Ursula and it's dead. We just one turn quest 400 power
as a free-to-play player. I just have no words. I'm just... Okay. We got another sun gem. Yes. Good. I don't know if I'll upgrade first of all Sleeping Lion or my counterpoint. I'm still not sure. Oh, I'm going to have to think about that. Oh, also. Just let the game load. And I'll tell you guys something cool. I'm not only going to do this Proud Plus quest. I'm going to do other Proud Plus quests right now. Like the speed one and the magic one. Because I can do them. But I have quite an unexpected set for you guys. You'll see. Okay, now we swipe. Okay, good. And it's so useful now that having Tyree, that she just restores 10 gauges, like... Ah! She just... I think she's one of the best medals in this game, guys. But... that's just me. I hope I can guild her, like... If they have an avatar board that has 2 making rooms, I'll totally buy that. Because then I will be able to guild her and get my tier 5. But... Let's go to the events. And let's go to the speed Proud Plus quest. Now this one, I have made quite an unexpected setup. And you'll see why. This is my setup now. You might be thinking, Ian, why Chip and Dale? Well, because of this. I got an extra attack 40% power on them. So, and I also got one on my Hercules and Phil. I have no idea. So what I'm going to be doing is the same strategy as Madison B, but I'm going to bring in Nanyas. Yeah, Nan has decided to change his name to Nanya. Zigbar B with attack boost 3 max. And I tested this out, this works out. I didn't beat the quest obviously, but this does work out. So let me show you how it's done. We first of all use both of our buffers. Then we use Tyree. And then we use Hercules and Phil. Twice, I believe. Let's see. Yep, we used them twice. Boom. Now, we restore 8 gauges with Chip and Dale. And we use Nanya Zigbar B. This is the strategy, and it works. Like, it just works. Since we're having 18 gauges constantly, because if we didn't have this gauge restoring resource, we would be using 10. 11, 14, 20 gauges. And I'm constantly bringing back 8. So this is really a strong setup. Now we use Tyree. Now Hercules and Phil. And it should be enough to kill them all. Okay, so... I forgot what I did here. So I tap here. Now we use Chip and Dale twice. Yeah, and should I risk it? Nah, I'm not gonna risk it. I could risk trying to trigger Ariel's defense boost too, but I'm not going to. And it's dead. Okay. Let's keep going. Cannon gun. Now this one is the hardest one because he has plus 2 general defense. No, he has plus 2 attribute defense, but still. Attribute defense does matter quite a lot. So, we are going to use Hercules on field twice in this run. Against him. Let's see. 25,000 still. And then we restore our 8 gauges with Chip and Dale. And now we use Zigbar B. I saw some people that were saying that if you get the extra attack on Chip and Dale, you don't need to... Oh, no. Oh, defense boost 2. I saw some people that were saying that you don't need Tyree when you have the double EXP skill on... The double attack skill on Chip and Dale. And I disagree, like, if you have both of them, then you can do awesome strategies like this. Like, this is an unexpected strategy for me, but it works out. Oh, this is the guy that has the plus 2 general defense up. Okay. Since we still don't have SP attack gauge 2 and attack boost 3 max, this is the best I can do for this Proud Plus quest. Boom. If you guys can do something similar like this, then, well, I hope I helped you with a setup.
And I just don't know what to say. I'm just so happy with this update. And we got to the target. Okay. The plus 6 tiers of general strength help out quite a lot. Let's see. And I also have some really good ideas for setups in the future. Like, because I got so many good medals. But still, let's see. Hercules and Phil, go! 82,000 with no attack boost. Don't forget, I don't have any attack boost on these guys. Now, 18, and let's hope Zig Barbie is enough. I think he is. I think he is. Let's see. Yep, one turn almost everything. But still, one turn this prop plus quest. Yes. Freaking really, 10 minutes! You're giving me less and less time. Come on. Now, I have gotten some good medals, and I'll show you some strategies I may use in the future with these new tier 4 and 5 medals. So, just let the game load, and I'll show you. Okay. So, first of all, one of the main medals that I got was the Illustrated Sora B. Holy crap, I'm happy I got him. He is strong. I got him. Let me remove this. I got him. I also got... Where is she? Illustrated Chion that I may be able to put on my counterpoint when I have enough fits. I also got an HD Axel, which is also going to be really good, especially in my Starlight. I think Xemnas B is better for like raid bosses and stuff, and some story quests, and Axel is better for the Proud Plus quest, so definitely good to keep an eye out for him. What else did I get? I got more than one magic medal. Let's see, I got the KR2, which is, holy crap, this medal is really good. And what else did I get? Let's see, newest 6-star. I got SP Xion, which is not really great, but hey, she helps. And I got Illustrated Ventus. I'm back. Yes, Tyree's here. Yes, that's right, ENMD. So, this is going to be part of the Union Cross update video. And holy crap, this video is gonna be long. I still haven't edited it, but I know it's going to be really, really long. However, I need to advance on the story. I need jewels. I mean, I'm not sure if there is going to be an avatar board with Mickey and Brooms. If it does, I just need two more to guild Tyree. If not, then, well, I'll need to try my luck in pulling her. And in 10 days, I reached my 300th day. I don't know if I said that right, but yes, in 10 days I'm reaching my 300th day. So I'll get 500 jewels, and I'm not sure, I may be able to get 7,000 jewels more. But, well, let's see, I hope so, before April 24th. So, yeah, if I get 7,000 jewels in April, like, in April 24th, if I manage to get all of that, then I'll be able to guild my Tyree and get a Keyart 5, which I really, really want. I don't want to lose this opportunity. So this is telling us to equip the treasure trove, and it seems like these are the last quests for Aladdin's story, so let's see. Got any idea of how to find our way through those dunes? What? The nerve. Monsters. Here? Wait. What? The rubies. Oh, I just... Oh, they have the rubies. Good job, me. Okay, we're gonna have to catch these guys, then. It seems. I can't believe it. My only clue to finding a boo is gone. Oh, come on. We'll get them. You're right. We gotta get those rubies back. Let's go! Okay, let's finally end this story. Defeat the Red Bands and retrieve the rubies. Let's go! What do you have to say, Aladdin? Those bandits couldn't have gotten far. I'll check the desert. You search the town. Okay then, let's go. So this is where Aladdin's house reaches. Okay, the Aladdin maid is equipped the treasure trove. Oh no, no, I don't want to quit. Okay. Oh yeah, I forgot. This Tyria has the +2 gauge skill. So she is giving us 2 extra gauges. Okay. I'm secretly hoping I get 7,000 jewels so I can do a second pull. Wait a second, guys. Just wait 1 second. My mom's listening to music, but I don't know if it's getting the recording, but however, that doesn't matter. I'm not sure if... Actually, kind of secretly... I am secretly hoping I manage to get plus 7,000 jewels for... So I can do a pull and get a trade on her. Because trades are really big right now. They're really important to the game. And I really want to see... If I pull for a second Tyrie, which trade I'll get on her? Are there any enemies back here? Although, why am I having such difficulty to speak today? Okay, nothing here. Doesn't seem like there's anything. It's like, even if I get like plus 800 HP, I'm good. And you may have noticed that my Nova is level 217. The reason why is because I leveled up and combined some metals to make some trades. And I got a really good trade on a metal I wasn't really expecting, but that is welcome nonetheless. So I'll show you guys. Actually, I'll show it right now. I'm gonna do this recording part by part. I'm not gonna show all the quests. I'm going to show just the ones that have story, because these quests aren't really too difficult. They are meant to be easy. But we have 30 quests, I'm gonna have to record like 20 parts. So, let me show you guys the metal I got, a pretty good skill that I wasn't expecting. It was... Pooh Bear! So, I got an extra attack 40% power on my 5-star version. This is really good, because he raises the speed-based defense by 2 tiers for 1 turn. But on the level 4, 20 plus quest, he's gonna be really, really strong. Like, I even have a setup planned. I still haven't gotten there, but here's a setup that I'm planning. So, it's going to be exactly this. Wait, what? Stop with the message. I'm not sure what... You know what? No. This is going to be the setup. And... The 6 plus tiers are really necessary in this. I don't know, I think this is already really good. And I might bring in another Tyrie, I might... I'm not sure, guys. But I do have this Poo with +2 speed-based defense. And this will do big differences against the Dark Side, because the Dark Side is the strongest one. I'll need the maximum power I can get. But... Yeah, I'm gonna stop the recording right here, I'm gonna continue on to the story, and I'll be right back. Okay, next story quest with story. Let's see. I am bringing in this setup with Gachiku's 150% gilded gear 3. Congrats on that, dude! Congrats! Now let's take a look quickly at what we have. The story is going to be, obviously... Are we going to finally find that bandit that... defeated us in the beginning of the story, like way back in remember that bandit that defeated both me and Aladdin, or you and Aladdin at once, like with one swing of his sword? And I was like, what the heck, why did you lose so easily to him? Are we going to find that guy? I hope so, because I wanna defeat him. Okay, I don't need to use Marley B's attack anymore. I already did 15,000 or more damage within one hit. Excluding Nova. Oh, now let's assault the key art. Wait, how high is it? 7.81. Okay then, let's test it out. And boom, 8,000. Wow. With boss is going to be really strong. Oh, six. Oh yeah, he has the Gachiko's got the 800 plus HP on his key art 3, which is why it has 6,770 HP. Okay, let's take a look at what the story is. Bam. Dun, 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 dun. No, I'm not gonna sing, sorry. Oh, holy crap, this update for Union Cross was amazing. I hope we get more updates like this, like, just amazing updates in general. Okay, let's see what we get. What is the story going to be? Game. Please don't. Okay. Did we retrieve the rubies? It's great we got the rubies back. But? I still don't know what to do with them. I wish I knew how to find you, Abu. Oh, wait, it's glowing. What? Why are they glowing? Wait, are they going to teleport? Oh no, it just ran away. Great. Okay, this might be crazy, but I've got a hunch that if we head back to the Starless Sands, we'll find the rubies and Abu. So the ruby just flew off. Oh, hello, Jersey. Strange. It's like the rubies heard Aladdin's wish. Now, there's only one way to find out if his hunch was right. You know what to do. Abu, let's go. Okay then, follow the rubies. Follow Aladdin to the Starless Sands. Oh, raid boss. Okay then. Follow the rubies, let's go. Ooh, it seems as if we have been traveling for a long while because, well, it's night time already. Toquinho, stop it. Okay, so we have to defeat this guy within... Well, we have story. And guys, look at the setup. This is a setup that I just made. I have Kiar 2, Illustrated Shion, my Tyree... Toquinho! It's making it quite hard to speak because we can't listen. Well... This is my setup, like a good setup for three wishes. I would put Jack and Sally in here and then Kiar 2, but the problem is that I don't have enough seeds for the Kiar 2 yet. But it's just a test setup, and Axel asked me to use his Melisande B in a video, so here she is. She has no traits, which I find odd. Maybe he guilted her before the Union Cross update, but anyways, I'm saving up also some seeds for HDXO, and we are getting Vaccine B this month in a few days, so... Oh no, I lost the first dialogue. The rubies are lighting the way through the desert. I think he just said look. But wait, today is April 9th, so I have to be quick on... recording the rest of the parts and... Wait. Ooh, shiny! Okay. We have to defeat all enemies within one turn. Okay then. So, here's Kiar 2's animation for those of you that haven't seen it yet. So, it deals 4 extremely powerful hits and lowers the magic base defense of all targets. And here's Illustrated Shion's animation. She lowers general defense by one turn, so she's really good. I would put her on Mughal Glory, except I already have Malefic be guilted, so... And at 100%. Oh, lots of shadows. Let me see. And let's use Tyree here to restore gauges. Okay. And I'm gonna use Axos... Oh! Also guys, for the eggs, you don't need to try to get a lot of hits if you have Tyree. You can just do this. Boom! They're dead. Okay. Where there's a fat Hello there, Shadow. There's a fat bandit that the game wants me to find. Here it is. End of it within one turn. So, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to use her. Then I'm going to tap you. I'm going to use Shion. Then I'm gonna use Tyrio crap. Swipe, swipe. Oh, I wasn't able to use Axles. I was going to try to do quite a lot of buffing, so he would do some damage, but it doesn't seem like that's gonna work. But let's try the same strategy here, except I'm not gonna use, well, either Kiark or Xion. Just, no, wait, swipe, swipe, swipe. Okay, let's see how much Axel's Mugsin B deals. 12,000, not bad. See, Axel, use your friend metal. Are you happy? Well, not bad. 12,000 for a shard metal is not bad. However, Mugsin B can deal up to 40,000 damage per hit with the correct buffing and debuffing. So, yeah, I'm not sure if I'll share mine. I mean, I have Tyree. I'm probably going to guild her. I'm gonna try to guild her. I'm going to wait a little bit to see if I pull or if there will be an avatar board with... No, actually there won't be an avatar board with Mickey and Brooms this month. Oh, I just noticed that. Oh, crap. Because if we go to take a look at the notices, within the 12 notices that we got the flashy party avatars, which are the juggler and dancer, and they don't have any... they don't have any Mickey and Brooms, and the returning avatar boards, none of them have Mickey and Brooms also. They only have what they originally had, like seriously, attack boost 1. I don't get why anyone would want defense boost 1, attack boost 1. Oh, it's because of the Nick Wilde and Judy Hoff's buffers. Okay, gotcha. But, well, just a tip, if you were to buy one of the previous avatar boards, I would suggest either Kinohatsu Roxas or Kinohatsu Namine, or Halloween Donald, because of his build that has a skill perk and because of his attack price plus. Goofy is also good for the no cost, but no cost only has a 50% chance of activating. And if you buy the new avatar, you get an SP attack gauge 1, which has a 100% chance to trigger. So, yeah, but I'll be right back, guys. Just a bit. Whoa, another story quest already? Like, oh, and also, this quest right here. Make sure to verify all 9 rooms. Yes, there are 9 rooms. Make sure to check all of them if you are to complete it with all objectives. And there are enemies that are hidden from sight until you get near them. So be sure to check every sand particle in this quest. But let's go to quest 581. Let's see what it has to show us. Okay. So, let's bring Gachikus, 150% Gilded Gear 3. A cave? I guess the legends were true. They say the Ruby's light will show the way to a bandit hideout. That must be why they tried to steal them earlier. Abu has to be in there. Come on. Is it the Cave of Wonders? I hope so. I hope it's the Cave of Wonders because the Cave of Wonders is cool. Okay. So we have to defeat all enemies in one turn, do 20,000 or more damage with one hit. I don't think that's really hard considering Marley B exists. Let's see, tap, tap, and you are 60,000 damage. What? What the heck? I was like, okay, let's shoot for a moderate amount, like 60,000, 155,000. What the heck? Okay then, I'm not complaining. It's just unexpected. Like, really unexpected. I know Marley B is too strong, but still. Like, what the heck? Okay. Also, these objectives with 20,000 or more damage with one hit. If you guild Tyree, like, at max guild, these suddenly become, like, really easy to accomplish. Okay, So let's use KR5 just in case. And boom! 23,000 damage. Okay then. Whew. And guys, am I the only one that's hoping this high score, this month's high score challenge is the Lock, Shock, and Barrel and Oogie Boogie one? Am I the only one that's hoping that? Because now that we have the traits, I really want a Lock, Shock, and Barrel with the extra attack 40% trait and in Oogie Boogie. Just plain old Oogie Boogie. Because, well, Lock, Shock, can be so helpful in so many setups, like Divine Rose, Lady Luck if I were ever to use that. What else? The Sleeping Lion, the Aching Heart, the new Revert Keyblade for Speed in Japan. There's so many good things you can do with Lock, Shock, and Barrel and Oogie Boogie. He would be great on Fenrir. Starlight, even freaking Olympia, he would be awesome. So I just hope we get their high score challenge soon. I really want their medals. But guys, be right back with quest 585. Here he is, the Wily Bandit. So this is his name. Okay, so this is the guy that defeated us before. The number above the monster gets smaller as you attack. Once it reaches zero, watch out. Don't let his conniving crook rob you of your HP. I won't. Now, let me see if I have enough gauges. So, 3, 4... Yes, I have just enough. Wow. Okay then. We have to defeat him within 2 turns. A doorway! Abu must be through there. You? He was just waiting for us. Come on. I remember you. You're the creep who took Abu. Now this is a boss fight. Give me back my friend. Do I have a chest? Let's see. Do we have a chest? Please, game. Wow, this is a long set of stairs. Nope, no chest. Great. So, we're gonna have to be really lucky with the gauges. Okay then, let's go. Oh, plus 23? Really? That's all? Okay then. Okay. Go beast! 7,000, and he's not even in the colored spot. Okay, go Meowgesy! Oh, come on Meowgesy. Well, this is... Am I gonna one-turn him? Am I seriously gonna one-turn him? Let's see. I think I just one-turn him, guys. Was this supposed to be easy? Because it wasn't. Aladdin couldn't even do anything, poor guy. Well, he's dead. We did it, complete it within 1 turn. Yay. And we got a title. And our Calcom. We got the Joker. Joker? Why Joker? This guy isn't a Joker. Well, anyway. Let's see. Just let the game load, as always. And now let him deliver the finishing blow. Oh, no, wait. It was a boo. Abu! Aw, that's cute. Oh, come on, it's me! It's okay, Abu. This is my new friend. He helped me find you. Hello there, Abu! Oh, come on, why don't you like me? Calm down. No one's ever gonna replace you. You're my best friend. Oh, come on, Abu. EMD, I'd like you to meet Abu. Now, Abu, be nice. Oh, he liked me, okay. I'm so glad we found you, Abu. Now, what do you say we head home? Okay, then let's go. Hmm? Let me guess. You have to leave, don't you?
Abu's sad now. Well, thanks for everything. If it weren't for you, I never would have found Abu.
I owe you one. Come back to Agrabah soon, okay?
Okay then.
We'll be waiting. And there they go. Hello, Jersey. Their friendship is what really led the way in that dark desert. By following his heart, Aladdin reunited with Abu.
Jersey almost seems like a narrator at times. If you follow your heart, maybe you'll see your friend again too.
Ephemer and Scold. I hope I can see them soon too. And now, let's go to the Castle of Dreams. We have to equip the 3 Wishes Keyblade. A whole new world. Ha, I can do that reference because we were just now in the Aladdin world. Ha ha. No one can stop me. Okay. Friend Metal, Axel, let's go. Let's see how the story is in here. Why am I in the Castle of Dreams suddenly?
Wow, what a grand palace.
Too bad we're here on business, not pleasure. What are we doing here to start?
That's right, darkness is spreading.
Oh, of course it is.
Well, I'll vanquish it with my Kiwi.
You don't need much more help, do ya? That says a lot about me as your mentor, you know. But we can talk about that later. There's darkness to banish.
Oh, this is terrible. How will I carry out the king's orders?
Not by just standing there.
What's this?
You'll do away with these fiends?
I will.
Well, then you have my deepest gratitude. If it wouldn't be too much, might also ask a favor.
Okay then.
Would you be so kind as to make a delivery to the chateau that's just...
Are you seriously making me your delivery man?
Come on! It's a very urgent and important message from His Imperial Majesty. I trust it will be handled with the utmost care.
Okay then.
You have my thanks, and that of the king. Now I must be off. I'm to visit all the eligible maidens in the kingdom before nightfall.
Meanwhile, I'm just standing here waiting for you to leave so I can defeat some heartless.
What the heck was that? He wants me to be his Oh!
Well, this is an accurate representation.
I mean... He was surrounded by heartless.
Okay then.
Tap away! Swipe, swipe, swipe! Oh, I can't get to Axel's medal. Oh no. Okay. I think now I can. So, swipe, tap... Tap, use this one, I don't think I should have used that, and I'll tap here, I'll swipe here, and use Axel, let's see how much damage Axel deals. And, 10,000, not that, but, well, I have already used Axel before, so this is just to make him happy, right Axel? Okay, so let's keep on going through the woods, I need to deliver this important message it seems. Well, this is the start of our journey. I don't know in which quest we get the new Keyblade. Is it on... Okay, I'm just gonna keep going and I'll be right back, guys. Just let the game load. Oh, right, boss. Okay, we'll be right back. Okay, finally got to the next story quest. With actual story, like... This took quite a few quests. So let's see what we have here. So... True to his name, this hospital horror covers the HP of its allies. Defeated before yourself in a never-ending battle. Okay then, seems scary enough. Let's take a look at what the story is. Okay, we're gonna have to wait to defeat this guy first. Two high wizards that it wants me to defeat. Oh, this one's by attacks, okay. Well, the good thing is that none of these deal too much damage, so... But wait. It's a never-ending battle, it only heals once. Grab this chest, another wizard. And if you hear something in the background, that's my mother, she's needing. She's kind of on a allergic streak. So yeah. Okay, grab this chest. Okay, so I just don't grab the materials for the new keyblade, the Stroke of Midnight. Okay. Tap, tap, Tyree, and Lightning. I just want to be quick because, yes guys, I have checked, it's gonna be a over 1 hour video, so. Yeah, I definitely need to edit this quick because it's already 8:30 PM on Sunday. So I need to be quick if I want to post this before Monday. Okay, here is the enemy. So I have pretty easy strategy to deal with him. Boom, he's dead. Okay, so we finally got to the house. Let's see what do we deliver. Let's see. Okay then,
please load.
Okay, it loaded. Let's just check in really quickly. Okay.
Let's hope it goes quickly. Come on, game. Come on.
Okay. Let's see. Wait, what? You know, why was I going to break in? Sometimes a little knocking can do the trick. Yes, that's right. Why was I going to barge in? Yeah, no keyblade in hand. And I will take off the balloon genie. Won't you come in? Oh, hello there. I have a letter for you. Oh, is that a letter for my stepmother? Wait, she just throws it. Why, it's the royal seal. I wonder where it could be. Thank you. No problem. I'm leaving. For some reason. Jacques! No! What the heck? Hey, you wait a bit, Jacques. Oh, don't tell me that was all. Okay, 595, so... Wait, complete within 10 turns and 45 seconds? Dude, I think I'm gonna need some real heavy setup, like, what the heck? I don't even know how to think right now. Right. Yeah, Moana. Moana is going to be the best option. Mouse and A, Mouse and E. Let's go. Okay, 45 seconds and I have 10 turns to beat this. Okay, let's go. Oh, what the heck? No. Stop. And I have to defeat all enemies in one turn, so quick. Let's go. Wait, that's it. Okay, quick. Ah! Boom. Okay, I did it. Whew. That was way more stressful than it should be. Jacques, are you there? No, he ran away. No, he didn't. I'm just dumb. Let's keep going. Okay. And jewels and money. Stroke of Midnight, here it is. Woo! Okay, on Wednesdays, I have to keep in mind. On Wednesdays, we have the material quest and the adamantite ore challenges for the Stroke of Midnight. So, gotta remember that. You say Jacques, thanks. And it's just normal that the mouse speaks. Sorry. Huh? You know what Jacques say?
Well, it seems as if I do. Just like Cinderella. I'm Jacques. Nice to meet you.
I mean, Andy. Why were Heartless chasing you?
Cinderella. She's a friend. She's nice. Very nice. I show you. This way.
And I'm just going back in like it's my own home.
Okay, then. Okay, I'm gonna be right back, guys. I'm gonna do this really quickly. There's only 4 more quests.
Okay, guys. I got here to the last enemy. And I actually checked the quest. And he has a counter above his head of 4. So what I'm gonna be doing is that I switch out Sebastian for Piglet because Piglet is single target. This is a problem because I am losing a whole tier of strength. However, I think this is worth it. So, the main thing is Igbar be proccing in this case. And so, let's hope he does. I mean, I'm just hoping he does. Let's get all the materials and a chest that's down here. It's probably gonna be a Moogle medal and not worth it. However, hey. Okay, so 28 bars. I think Zipper Beat can take him. Especially considering he's a story boss, so let's see. Okay, Moana, please trigger! She did not trigger. And he didn't trigger either. Ah! Okay, it didn't allow me to use Molesson B. Great. Okay. So it seems as if I'm going to have to use Nova here, or I'm going to have to rely on luck. Okay, go Moana, go! Attack boost to triggered, and please let me use Igbar. Are you? Okay, use Nova. Now what? Let me use Maleficent. She didn't trigger. But it was enough. Yes! Okay. Okay, we did it. Within 2 turns. Wow, this is really fun when the guy gets to attack you before you get to attack him, huh? And wanna do 100,000 damage, I mean, that's just crazy. And we got the title presently. And another Orichalcum for our Stroke of Midnight. I need to remember that name, I always forget it for some reason. But let's take a look at the story. We went up the stories of Cinderella's home. Let's see. Oh, the dress. A ball at the palace. And by royal command, every eligible maiden is to attend. But of course, I'll need something to wear. Perhaps I could make a few adjustments to my mother's dress. Oh, hello, Jacques. I see you've brought the royal messenger.
I'm not really a royal messenger.
No, this is Jacques' friend. Good friend. Why, that's wonderful. I'm Cinderella. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Me too.
Cinderella! 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 Alright, I'm coming. I guess my dress will just have to wait. Poor Cinderella. She not go to the ball.
But I thought she was preparing.
You see, they'll fix her. Work. She'll never get her dress done. And it ends there. What a sad note to end on. However, this is probably going to follow the Birth by Sleep story in which we help her to fix the dress. Now, this is counterpoint, and I know it seems ugly, it's like, what the heck? Why is this a setup? But I believe that's how it works. Wait, I already have 58 small buttons? Okay, then let's just upgrade everything.
Tokituka!
Tokituka, they don't stop barking. And this is a reverse power slot, which is the first time I saw it on a
keyblade like this, like that has all three attributes. Let's just keep upgrading it until we cannot anymore. Let's see. Large pearls. Ooh, we are using materials also. Okay then. And yes, this is a magic attribute. Magic spot. Okay, but it's going to be in that magic upright, but I don't care. Let's just keep going. This is going to be the last thing of today's video, guys. Oh, I can't. I need a handkerchief. Okay. Guys, sorry this video was really long. However, I wanted to do a whole update video. I wasn't able to. This is a Trunk of Midnight Keyblade. And there's one more thing that I'm going to do on another day. Because this video is already way too long. It's already over 1 hour. I'm sorry for making it this long, but I just wanted to do everything. Mostly everything that I could before the next update, which is going to be tomorrow. So yeah, let me just, the next video probably after the update video for tomorrow is going to be the anniversary quests. So these are going to be my next objective after the tomorrow's update. So this is going to be my next video, guys. But either way, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you are enjoying this update of Union Cross. And I hope you get along well with this update, that everything worked out fine, you did some fine pulls, you bought some good avatar boards, you're having fun with multiplayer. If you want me to do a more in-depth analysis of everything, I can. But it's probably going to have to wait up until Friday, because Friday is... I have the day off from school. So anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope you're not disappointed that it took too long. But yeah, guys, see you soon. And I hope you are liking Union Cross.